Hey guys, what's going on? It's Austin Shelby here. In this video, I want to show you how you can use React Hook Form with Zod as the validation library. Alright, let's just get right into it. If you want to follow along, the link to this project is in the description. Alright, so I prepared this project for us. It already has all the form ready and the styling, it just doesn't have React Hook Form or Zod plugged in, so we're gonna work on that. Let's start by importing Zed from Zod. And we're gonna use Zod for validation. So let's build the schema first. If we look at our form, we can see what fields we have. We have an email, which is a string. Then we have the checkbox to accept the terms of service. This is a Boolean. And for the payment tier, it's one of the strings, either bronze, silver, or gold. So let's build the schema to match this form. We're gonna make our schema an object because it has many key value pairs for the email, the terms of service, and the payment tier. The email is gonna be a string, but not just any string, it has to be a valid email address. Thankfully, Zod provides us with an email validation that we can chain with the string. This is one of the reasons why I like Zod so much. It comes with a lot of functionality out of the box. Then let's add the accept, which is gonna be a Boolean, as the checkbox can be either yes or no. Now, if you want to require that all users accept the terms of service, you can instead set the accept to a literal of value true. Now let's create the validation for our payment tier. It's a string, but not just any string. If you look at, we have this array called tiers that has many objects of all the available payment tiers. And we want the tier to be any of the IDs, so bronze, silver, or gold. We need to use a custom validation for this. And with Zod, it's called refine. Refine takes a function, and the value is gonna be the value that we're gonna be validating. And we wanna check if this value is any of the IDs of the tiers. So first, let's map over the tiers and just select their ID. And with this new array of only the IDs, we wanna check if it includes the value. Now that we have our form schema set up, let's infer a type from it. This will allow us to take the full advantage of TypeScript. Zod makes this very easy by providing the function infer that takes the type of the schema. If I hover over the form schema type, we can see that TypeScript correctly inferred all of the types. Now let's build our form and use this schema as the validation. I'm gonna import submit handler and use form from React Hook Form and Zod Resolver from Hook Form Resolvers. To add React Hook Form, we're gonna use the custom hook it provides, use form. And because it's a generic function, we can give it the type of our schema. To use our schema as the validation, we can give the use form an argument called resolver, which takes the Zod Resolver, which takes our schema. And then we're gonna grab two functions, register and watch from use form. I'm gonna show you a cool trick that I use all the time to debug my forms. At the end of the form, I'm gonna add a pair of pre tags. And inside of them, I'm gonna change on stringify the return of the watch function. This is gonna show the state of the form. When I change some of the form values, we can see that the state doesn't change at all. This is because we haven't yet registered the inputs. To register the inputs, we need to use the register function and give it the name of the input that matches the one in our schema. So for our email input, we're gonna register email. For our terms of service checkbox, we're gonna register accept. And for our payment tier, we're gonna register tier. Now when I change the field values on the form, we can see that the state changes accordingly. Now to handle submitting the form, we need to also get the handle submit from use form. Let's create a function that's gonna get called whenever we submit the form. Let's call it onSubmit. And let's give it the type submit handler that we get from Zod. Because it's a generic type, we can give it the type of our schema. The function takes one argument, which is the validated data of our form. And for now, we're just gonna log it into the console. And in our form tags, we're gonna use the onSubmit event handler and give it the handle submit and onSubmit. Now when I fill up the form and click on Create Account, we can see it successfully logged the form values into the console. But what about if there's an error in the form? I'm going to enter an invalid email and not check the Accept the Terms of Service checkbox. And when I click on Create Account, nothing happens. We don't even see any error. To fix this, next thing we need to do is show the errors in the form. From the use form, we're gonna also get form state. And because form state is also an object, we can destructure it even further and get the errors object. Now to show the error, we need to first check if this field has the error, and if it has, we're gonna render a paragraph. And the paragraph is gonna have the message of the error. Let's save it and let's see if it works. I'm gonna submit this form with invalid email, and we can see that we get the correct error message. Now let's copy and paste this for the other inputs too. After that is done, when I try submitting the form with all fields invalid, we can see that the error messages are working correctly. But the messages are pretty unclear. I mean, what does expected boolean received boolean mean? Let's change the error messages to be more clear. To customize our error messages, we need to edit our form schema. Let's look at the accept first. The literal function takes another argument, which is an object, where we can give our error message. The string validation on the tier also takes an object, where we can give a correct error message. I'm gonna submit the form and we can see that now we have the correct error messages. Let's take a closer look at the form. It's pretty simple at this point. And we are creating an account. You would probably have to save the user to the database, which obviously takes a lot of time. So let's try to emulate this functionality by creating some additional delay whenever we submit the form. First, we're gonna change our function to an asynchronous function. Inside the function, we're gonna await for a new promise to resolve. And the promise is also going to take an asynchronous function. Inside that function, we're gonna wait for a timeout of 3 seconds. And whenever the timeout resolves, we're gonna log the data into the console and then resolve the promise. Alright, let's see what happens now when we submit the form. I'm gonna fill the form and press on Create Account. And as you can see, it takes 3 seconds until the data gets logged into the console. But what happens when I click on the Create Account multiple times in a row? Oops, looks like after the 3 second delay, it logged it into the console multiple times, which is what we don't want to happen. I mean, this would cause the user to be saved in the database multiple times. So what we want to do is avoid submitting the form multiple times. And we can do this by disabling the inputs and the submit button whenever the form is submitting. From the form state, we're gonna get another value, is submitting. And as the name tells, this value will be true whenever the form is currently submitting. And for the inputs, we can just disable them whenever the form is submitting. Let's add it to all of our inputs and the submit button. Now, when I fill the form and click on Create Account, we can see all the fields get disabled. And after 3 seconds, the data gets logged into the console and we can submit the form again. So it works correctly. And this is just one of the many reasons to use React Hook Form and Zod. It just makes creating forms so easy and fun. In the future, I'm gonna create more tutorials just like this, going over some more advanced examples. So if you wanna see those, please hit the subscribe button. Alright, thank you so much for watching, and I see you next time.